Today's topic is the fall equinox and the sun entering Libra. Stay tuned. Hello, beautiful warriors. Thank you so much for coming back for another video. If you're new here, make sure that you hit the subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss out on videos just like this. I post every single Tuesday here. So if you're excited to learn about the equinox and Libra season, make sure you hit the like button and comment Libra in the comment section below. Now let's dive into the video. So right now we're celebrating Mabon, and this is an ancient Celtic holiday which really celebrates everything that we've harvested over the warm months. So people used to grow things over the warm months, and then they would harvest it, and then they would hold on to it for storage during the winter time. And there is an element of gratitude and giving thanks around Mabon. There is an element of giving gratitude for all of the things that we've grown and all the things that we've harvested, and really counting your blessings and also taking your blessings into the colder months. So it's also an acknowledgement that the colder months are coming, and whatever it was that we harvested, we can take with us into the darkness. And luckily, now this is very metaphorical. So in ancient times, it was very physical, right? They would actually physically harvest food and carry it with them into the winter months. Now it's more so metaphorical. So think about, and I would like to invite you guys at this point to really think about what you have harvested metaphorically, what blessings were given to you over the warm months, what did you learn, what were you given, whether that could be physical, it could be metaphorical, maybe it was a new relationship, maybe it was, I don't know, maybe you got a really amazing opportunity. Take a moment to just really reflect on anything that really blessed you this summer. And you can pause this video and make a list of all of the things that you feel grateful for. So essentially, I want to bring gratitude in because that will allow us to kind of pivot into the next topic, which is balance. So we can take that bright energy, that positive energy into the darkness with us. And that allows us to hold on to balance and to maintain the balance. And so if you want to take a moment to pause this right now, you can. If not, you can just stay with me. So bringing this positivity and this beauty into the balance is a theme. The equinox and Libra are both very focused on balance. So the equinox is when the nighttime and the daytime are almost equal at length. And Libra is also all about balance, but from another way. So the equinox really represents the balance of natural forces, whereas Libra seeks balance in other ways. And it does so through beauty oftentimes. It's ruled by the planet of Venus, and Venus is all about beauty. And so Libra finds balance in the beauty of all things. And it's important to really give gratitude and really think about the beauty of our lives and take it with us into times that metaphorically feel dark. So that is the beauty of where we are right now. And I'll also dive into the chart for when the sun actually moves into Libra. Now, I want to first acknowledge, and this is also very present in the chart. If I look off to the side, I'm looking at the chart. This is also very present in the chart. We've had some really difficult energies playing out in the chart and obviously playing out in our world. We're in the middle of a pandemic and we've had all of these racial, important racial issues come to the surface, and these are not exactly easy times. So it's not exactly this energy of the sun going into Libra and all of a sudden we can sort of find balance and peace and justice, right? There's kind of gray area and we all need to do our part. And that's really what I focus on when it comes to astrology, is how can you do your part? How can you actually be self-aware and go within yourself and to identify the things that sort of need to be looked at, and then really heal and move forward from that place so we can affect the collective. So I'm gonna be diving in astrologically on a collective scale and also an individual scale. So collectively, like I said, we're kind of going through a hard time right now. And there is this crazy energy happening in Capricorn, and that's been really tough. And if you've been watching my videos, you know that Mars has been incredibly frustrated. And if you haven't watched them recently, definitely go check them out, because that'll give you some more context into what I'm going to be saying today. But essentially, I don't want to bypass the fact that we are in hard times right now. I want to completely validate that and acknowledge that. And we can do our part individually to bring balance. So one thing I want to mention on a collective level is, like I said before, to look at the beauty underneath the ugliness and to balance it in that way. So, and I know that this is really hard. So I know that there has been a lot of things coming out around really important racial issues, and so unfortunately there's been death, there's been violence, there's been just awful events that have taken place. But underneath it all, now people are starting to listen. Now things are all over the media. People are really starting to talk about things that we should have been talking about a really long time ago. And that is kind of like the beauty to the situation. And I know that that's kind of a tough thing to say, like, how could there be beauty to that situation? But that's how we bring balance into really into dark times, right? We look at what is actually growing underneath it, what is actually being cleared away, right? We're in autumn now, and nature is doing this thing right now where it just knows to let go of whatever is not serving. And that's kind of what we're doing right now. Things are kind of shedding and letting go, and there's something underneath the surface that's coming up. And I think that that really truly is very beautiful and very, very needed. So I also want to speak to that on an individual level and ask you guys to really go within yourself and see how that's playing out for you on an individual level. What are the really dark things that you're going through right now? What are the things that are maybe just not easy? There are things that are really challenging. What are the beautiful things that are kind of growing underneath the surface though, because of that situation? And one thing I would really like to mention here is there is a transit happening with Venus, who is the ruler of Libra. And Venus is transiting through Leo. And this feels so aligned for me to say right now. This has been coming up for me a lot. For my equinox ritual, I did it with one of my very, very dear friends. And we actually did a meditation where we sat in our sovereignty, and we were connecting with our being a queen, connecting with being this regal being connected to the queendom or the kingdom, right? And this is very much so what Venus in Leo has to say, is also through all of the darkness and all of the chaos and all the challenging times, whether that's collectively or individually or both, it's important to maintain your sovereignty and to stay balanced in your sovereignty. In meditation, oftentimes we're being told to maintain our posture. And in the tradition that I studied, when you have your back straight during meditation, when your spine is straight, you are making a statement to the universe that you are a queen or you are a king, and whatever comes up during meditation, even if it's hard, even if it's something that you didn't necessarily expect, you maintain your posture and you keep going through it. And there is energy around that right now, which I really, really love. It's an invitation to just remember to maintain your straight spine and your straight back through the difficult times. Now, I also want to mention that there is a grand trine happening with the fire signs when the sun enters Libra. Now, this is kind of tricky because while there is a grand trine, which is very harmonious, there is harmony happening between the fire signs, there's also this tough energy playing out between Mars and Capricorn still. And so there's still this energy around, yes, like there's a lot of passion and that's really great. And also make sure that you're learning how to be responsible about your passion. There's still that energy sort of playing out. So I just want to dive deep into that a little bit further and say that when it comes to Libra, when it comes to restoring balance and bringing peace, Libra is an energy that is all about contemplation. It is the only sign of the zodiac that is classified by represented by an object. So it's represented by the scales. And this is to represent its contemplation, how it contemplates by nature. Whenever Libra takes action, it's very thoughtful. It's thoughtful in the way of how do I create balance and harmony and peace through my actions. So there's kind of a lesson to fire playing out right now. Fire is sort of learning a lesson right now where it's kind of being asked to really, yes, it's great that you have passion. It's great that you have the ability to move forward and initiate and all of those things, but also make sure that you're contemplating on how your actions will affect other people and where in your life are you moving forward and you're just direct and you're thinking about you, maybe not necessarily thinking about other people when you just charge forward. So there's an invitation here to kind of focus on your relationships and where that is coming up. Libra is very tied into relationships. It's very tied into love because it's ruled by Venus, and it naturally is very geared to cater to relationships, and it seeks balance through relationships. And when relationships are not in harmony, Libra gets very upset. So, where in your life is your fire sort of getting in the way of you maintaining balance and maintaining harmony? Where in your life, specifically in your relationships, how is that playing out? And think about how you can sort of think about how you can restore balance and beauty into the situation. With this, there comes a responsibility, right? We're talking about this Capricorn Mars thing that keeps happening. It's been happening for a while. Mars is really being given a lot of life lessons around being responsible about your passion and being responsible about how you proceed forward and to really take responsibility for yourself and your passion and how that affects other people and if it brings disharmony and if it brings a disruption to peace into your life. So I am clearly having issues with my camera today. So I am going to end the video there, but thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope to see you here for the next one. If you want to book a reading with me, I'll be sure to include an Etsy link in the caption below so you can go ahead and book an astrology reading with me. I also sell metaphysical tools and just spiritual goodies. So if you want to check out my shop, definitely go ahead and check that out. If you liked this video, give it a like, share it with anybody who you feel like could benefit from it. Likes, shares, and comments are always appreciated, and I will see you here for the next video.